Don't blame me
for falling.
I was just a little boy.
Watermelon sugar.
Just trying to be in there. Tell me how you feel.
That first night we were standing at your door.
And I feel like nothing's gonna hold me down.
Fumbling for your keys and I kiss you.
When I'm sorry,
I come running to you like a moth into a
flame. We can all belong.
Truly, man, you know how hard that is.
Yeah, man, it's definitely hard. And it took me, you know, it took me a good year, 18 months. What are you laughing at? My accent. Yeah, it's funny, isn't it? Anyway, if I could speak, if that's all right, love. You know, when I spent a long time trying to find exactly what my sound was. And to be fair, when I first went out on my own, I wasn't even sure that I was definitely going to make a solo record, you know, and kind of one thing led to another. And I kind of had to learn on the job who I am really as an artist, you know, because I'd only really looked at myself as, you know, the lad in a band. So all of a sudden I had to look at myself as an artist, as an individual. So that took a little bit of time, I think.
So talk to me, that's fascinating you say that, Louis. Talk to me about the moment, I guess, after you leave, the band goes their separate ways, that you... You're not thinking about a solo record. What was your apprehension? What was your hesitation going solo?
I just wasn't worried. If I'm being honest, I just wasn't ready for the band to go on a break, to be honest. Come on, Jesus. It surprised me to a certain degree. So I didn't have any plan in place or anything like that. I just thought that I was going to carry on writing for other people, but not necessarily for myself. And then, you know, like I'm sure a lot of people in this situation, I did a bit of writing, I liked some of the songs I was writing, I thought, yeah, I might as well have a crack with it.
But these high walls, they came up short. Now I stand taller than them all. These high walls never broke my soul. Night, I watched them all come fall. Down, I watch them all come falling down for you. For you.
Like Niall, for example. He's the most lovely guy in the world. Happy-go-lucky Irish, no sense of arrogance, and he's fearless. There are times I've thought, I'd have a bit of that. Zane, back in the day, he could relate to me on a nerves level. In the first year, we were both the least confident, but Zane has a fantastic voice, and for him, it was always about owning that. Liam always had a good stage presence, same as Harry. They've both got that ownership. Harry comes across very cool. Liam's all about getting the crowd going, doing a bit of dancing. And then there's me.
Wish that you could build a time.
looking at the stars and wishing you were them. What do you do when a chapter ends? Do you close the book and never read it again? Where do you go when your story's done? You can be who you were, who you'll become. Oh, if it all goes wrong. Oh, darling, just hold on. Looking back in every mirror, I know you'll be waiting, I'll see you again. But you once told me, don't give up. You can do it day by day. And diamonds, they don't turn to dust or fade away. Fade away. So I will keep you day and night.
Something that I feel 100% comfortable talking too much about, but just quickly, yeah, when I first found out about the news, I kind of did want to throw the towel in, you know. But it was my mum who said to me that I just got to keep going. She told me very sternly that she wanted me to. Yeah, well, do you know what? Honestly, it's a really weird feeling because now I know that was the hardest day in my career.
I mean, without doubt.
And because I've done that, it gives me this weird confidence that I know that in terms of emotionally, I've been taken to the nth degree and I still managed to perform because that's what she wanted me to do. So it kind of gives me a little bit of confidence, you know what I mean? I've been to the nth degree there.
Poor mercy, mercy on me, set fire to history. I'm breaking my own rules. I'm crying like a fool. Tall stories on the page, sure glories on the fade. I've been close enough to touch, but I never cared for love. It's a church of burnt romances, and I'm too far gone to pray. It's a solo song, and it's only for the brave. Truth tell, darling, you feel like there ain't enough dying stars in your sky. It's a tall tale, and it's only hello, hello, no goodbye.
Making the fans feel included is very, very important to me across this whole process. You know, I'm conscious of them when I'm writing, when I'm putting the video together, you know, whatever it might be. And I just like them to feel part of the process, you know. Other people do it different and, you know, they kind of go for more of the aspirational kind of outlook. But for me, I want the fans, or I want me to feel like one of them and like we're doing it together as a team. It's important to me. You know, like any artist really, each artist is elevated and empowered by their own fans and the feeling that they give you, you know. And they really do. I mean, they're an amazing, amazing, you know, group of people. We recently did some promo for this single and we did like these global hotspots, so different locations, and people were like driving for hours to go to these locations. And yeah, they're just so dedicated, so loyal.
There's no use crying over spilled blood. Caring only kills love. A kiss won't bring it back. I know that the first blow it's too cold. I
to your long term. So let this be your comfort. You're not the only one, no. In a strange way, all in this together. Been this way forever. You're not the only one. I know that the first blow hits you cold.
A copy of a copy.